Now let's go to the next layer of the stack, the foundation models. These are only possible, of course, because of these advanced systems I talked about. Generative AI models span from trillions of parameter LLMs that require these most powerful GPUs in Azure to a few billion parameter task-specific small language models, or SLMs. And we offer the best selection of frontier models which you can use to build your own AI apps while meeting your specific cost, latency, and performance needs. And it starts with our deep, deep partnership with OpenAI. They're just doing stunning breakthrough work to advance the state of AI models, and we are thrilled to be all in on this partnership together. And our promise to you is simple. As OpenAI innovates, we will deliver all of that innovation as part of Azure AI. And we are bringing the very latest of GPT-4, including GPT-4 Turbo, GPT-4 Turbo with Vision, to Azure OpenAI service. Yeah, you can clap for that. You know, GPT-4 Turbo offers lower pricing, structured JSON formatting, which is sort of my favorite, and extended prompt length. You can, in fact, fit 300 pages of text now into a single prompt. GPT-4 Turbo will be available in Azure OpenAI service this week in preview, and the token pricing for the new models will be at parity with OpenAI. Also, soon, you'll be able to connect GPT-4 Turbo with Vision to Azure AI Vision, allowing you to prompt with video images and text. In fact, our customer WPP is already using this today with one of their largest clients. I mean, take a look at the video behind me. Pretty amazing to see video prompts as inputs and with summaries coming out on the other end. It's fantastic to see it. Finally, we will be introducing fine-tuning of GPT-4 on Azure OpenAI service as well, allowing you to bring your own data to create these custom versions of GPT-4. You know, we are also all in on open source and want to bring the best selection of open source models to Azure and do so responsibly. Our model catalog has the broadest selection of models already, and we are adding even more to our catalog. With Stable Diffusion, you can generate beautiful immersive images. With Code Llama, you can generate code. Mistral 7B, you can translate and summarize text. With NVIDIA's Nemotron 3 family of models, you can build general purpose AI apps. All these capabilities are deeply, deeply integrated with our safety guardrails. And today, we are taking one more big step in support of open source models. We're adding a new models as a service offering in Azure. You know, this, yeah, it is a big deal. It makes it simple. Because this will allow you to get access to these large models that are all available in open source as just hosted APIs, right? Without you as developers having to provision GPUs so that you can focus on development, not backend operations. We're excited to be partnering with Meta on this. It starts with Llama 2 as a service. You can fine-tune Llama 2 with your data to help the model understand your domain better and generate more accurate predictions. We want to support models in every language and in every country. And we are partnering with Mistral to bring their premium models as a service, as well as with Group 42 to bring JS, the world's highest quality Arabic language model, again, just as a service. Now, when we talk about open source, there's one more very exciting thing that's happening in this space, and that is SLMs. Microsoft loves SLMs. In fact, one of the best is Phi, a model that is built by Microsoft Research on highly specialized data sets, which can rival models that are even 50 times bigger. In fact, Phi 1.5 has only 1.3 billion parameters, but nonetheless, you know, it just demonstrates state-of-the-art performance against benchmarks testing things like common sense, language understanding, and logical reasoning. And today, I am thrilled to announce Phi 2. You know, it's a scaled-up version of Phi 1.5 that shows even better capabilities across all of these benchmarks while staying pretty small. I mean, relatively small at 2.7 billion parameters. In fact, it's 50% better at mathematical reasoning. And Phi 2 is open source and will be coming to our catalog as well as models of service. Once you have these models, you know, the next up is the tooling consideration. With Azure AI Studio, we offer the full lifecycle tool chain for you to be able to build, customize, train, evaluate, and deploy the latest next generation models. It also includes built-in safety tooling. Safety is the most important feature of our AI platform. It's not something we bolt on later, but we are shifting left from the very beginning. And with Azure AI Studio, you can detect and filter harmful user-generated and AI-generated content in your applications as well as your service. The other thing we're doing with Azure AI Studio is extending it to any endpoint, starting with Windows. You can customize state-of-the-art SLMs and leverage our templates for common developer scenarios so that you can integrate these models right into your applications. Right? When you combine the power of the cloud and the edge, it unlocks super compelling scenarios. Let's say you want to build an NPC helper for a game. You can start with an SLM like Phi or as your target model in Windows. We then help you compose solutions to steer your game to do what it needs, like the retrieval augmented generation templates to apply on your data set, to answer questions about quests. You know, this can all happen locally on your Windows machine. The NPC can guide players with their quests or even generate complete new storylines based on prompts from players. For more advanced use cases, you can adapt and fine-tune the SLM on Azure specifically for your game using the power of even frontier models like GPT-4. It's incredibly powerful to see all this come together. And of course, we're not stopping there. Earlier, I mentioned our partnership with NVIDIA. Together, we are innovating to make Azure the best cloud for training and inference. Our collaboration extends across the entirety of the stack, including our best-in-class solutions for AI development. Today, we are expanding our partnership by bringing NVIDIA's Generative AI Foundry service to Azure. Really, it brings together NVIDIA's foundation models, frameworks, tools, as well as its DGX Cloud AI supercomputing and services to provide the best end-to-end solution for creating generative AI models and custom generative models. To share more, I would like to invite up on stage the NVIDIA founder, president, and CEO, Jensen Huang, to join me.
Great seeing you.
Sounds good.
Jensen, thank you so much for being here. You know, this partnership, I talked a lot about all the things we've been doing on the system side. Of course, we wouldn't have been able to train the OpenAI models or make all this progress over the last few years without sort of the unbelievable systems work we've done. But today, we're even going a step beyond, bringing, in fact, all of the software innovation that you're doing. Do you want to share a little bit about what we're doing or you are doing on the software side on Azure?
I would love to. First of all, I'm so happy to be here to celebrate the amazing work of our two teams. This last 12 months, when I was just listening to you, unbelievable amount of progress for the whole computer industry, frankly, in the last 12 months. Well, our two teams have been super busy. AI and accelerated computing is a full stack challenge, and it's a data center scale challenge, from computing to networking, from chips to APIs. Everything has been transformed as a result of generative AI. Now, over the last 12 months, our two teams have been accelerating everything we could. Now, one of the initiatives, of course, is accelerated computing, offloading general purpose computing, accelerating all the software we can, because it improves energy efficiency, reduces carbon footprint, reduces cost for our customers, improves their performance, so on and so forth. We built the world's fastest AI supercomputer together.
Yep.
It usually takes a couple of 2-3 years to plan one, easily a year to stand one up. Our two teams built two of them, twins, one in your house, one in my house. We did it, and we stood it up in just a few months. It is now the fastest AI supercomputer in the world. And it seemingly without barely even trying, it's the third fastest supercomputer on the planet. It's really quite amazing. We worked on all kinds of computing breakthroughs. Confidential computing, of course, a very big deal, an invention between our two companies. All the way to deploying large language models from the cloud to the PC.
Yeah.
The work that we did together so that Windows can now be a first-class client for large language models opens up a few hundred NVIDIA-powered PCs and workstations around the world.
Yeah, it's the largest install base on the edge of very powerful AI machines. Happens to be Windows PCs with, you know, GPUs from NVIDIA.
That's right. That's right. And now with Studio AI, unbelievable, right? Everybody could be a RAG developer. Everybody could engage large language models. Now, we've also, and this is something that I'm so proud of, we talked about a year and a half ago, and this is such a great idea, such a great vision, and you really deserve so much credit for transforming Microsoft's entire culture to be so much more collaborative and partner-oriented, that NVIDIA's platforms, and you invited NVIDIA's ecosystem, all of our software stacks to be hosted on Azure. Today, we're announcing the two largest software stacks of our company, NVIDIA Omniverse, and in fact, just now you saw the WPP video. In fact, that's actually computer graphics. That computer graphics is running on Omniverse. And now you can connect Omniverse to generative AI. The second, and so Omniverse is for industrial digitalization. Today we're announcing that Omniverse Cloud, Omniverse, which is a stack originally on-prem on large computers, now available on Azure Cloud. The second is a brand new thing that we're announcing, and you just mentioned it. We're offering an AI Foundry service. Generative AI has opened up the opportunity for every enterprise in the world to engage artificial intelligence. For the very first time, it is now useful, versatile, quite frankly, easy to use.
Yep.
And companies all over the world will use it in multiple ways, but here's three basic ways. One, of course, public cloud services like ChatGPT. Second, embedded into applications like Windows. We are very, very happily also a full site licensed customer of Copilot.
Yeah.
And so we are going to be augmented by Microsoft Copilots. And if you think that NVIDIA is moving fast now, you know, we are going to be turbocharged by Copilot. And then third, of course, customers want to build their own AIs. Their own, they want to create their own, using their own data, create their own proprietary large language models, and create their own RAGs. And so today, leveraging what NVIDIA's core assets are, our AI expertise, our AI end-to-end workflow, NVIDIA AI Enterprise, and our AI factories, which is now available on Azure called DGX Cloud, we are going to make these, built on these three pillars, help customers build their own custom large language models. We're going to do for people who want to build their own proprietary large language models what TSMC does for us.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Right? And so we'll be a foundry for AI models.
Yeah, no, it's just so amazing to see. I mean, us partnering on everything on the system side and everything up the stack on the software side, whether it's on Omniverse or DGX Cloud and this AI Foundry is fantastic. I love that metaphor of TSMC for AI model development. You know, talking about this arc of AI, Jensen, of course, you've been, you know, at the core of this long before it became like fashionable to talk about it. You were talking about it. What's your arc here of AI innovation going forward?
Well, generative AI is the single most significant platform transition in computing history. You and I have both been in the computer industry a long time. In the last 40 years, nothing has been this big. It's bigger than PC, it's bigger than mobile, it's gonna be bigger than internet, and surely by far. This is also the largest TAM expansion of the computer industry in history. There's a whole new type of data center that's now available. Unlike the data centers of the past, this data center is dedicated to one job and one job only: running AI models and generating intelligence. It's an AI factory. This AI factory, you're building, you know, some of the world's most advanced, you're building the world's computer. That computer is now going to be augmented by AI factories all over. The second TAM expansion is where our industry has focused on building tools of the past. Now you have co-pilots that use the tools. So in hardware, there's a brand new segment, AI factories. In software, there's a brand new segment, co-pilots.
Co-pilots, yeah.
These are brand new things that the world's never had the opportunity to enjoy. Big, huge TAM expansion. The first wave is the wave that we've enjoyed, which is incredible startups at OpenAI and others who are part of the generative AI startups, cloud internet services. That's the first wave. We're now beginning the second wave, and is really triggered and kicked off by Copilot, Office or Windows 365 Copilot, basically the enterprise generation. The third generation, the third wave, is the wave that I think is going to be the largest wave of all. And the reason for that is because the vast majority of the world's industries run on it, which is heavy industries. And this is where NVIDIA's Omniverse and generative AI is going to come together to help heavy industries digitalize and benefit from generative AI. So we're really, quite frankly, barely in the middle of the first wave, starting the second wave. This is going to be.
I love that, three waves and all happening somewhat in parallel, but the staging of it, and I think it all accrues, it compounds across all three.
That's right.
Maybe we can close out, Jensen. You and I have worked together for decades. Microsoft and NVIDIA have worked together for decades. You know, partnerships are these magical things where your innovation, our innovation comes together ultimately to enable people in the audience. So just talk about, like, when you think about the Microsoft partnership, what's your vision for it? What's your expectations of it? And just any thoughts on that?
Well, we have a giant partnership. And many of you are partners with Microsoft here. And I think y'all agree with me that there's just a profound transformation in the way that Microsoft works with the ecosystem in the industry. We are suppliers to you, building the most advanced computers together. You're suppliers to us, and so we're customer partners with each other. But one of the things that I really, really love is the fact that we partner on advancing fundamental computer science like confidential computing and generative AI and all of the infrastructure that we built together. I love that we're inventing new technologies together, but I really love that you're hosting our native stack right there in Azure. And as a result, we're ecosystem partners. NVIDIA has a rich ecosystem of developers all over the world, several million CUDA developers, some 15,000 startups around the world works on NVIDIA's platform. The fact that they could now take their stack and without modification run it perfectly on Azure. My developers become your customers. My developers also have the benefit of integrating with all of the Azure APIs and services and the secure storage, the confidential computing. And so all of that richness amplifies NVIDIA's ecosystem. And so I think this partnership is really quite unique. I think that there's not one like it. We don't have one like it. We're incredibly proud of the partnership and incredibly proud of the work that we do together. And, you know, so I...
Thank you so much, Jensen. I really deeply appreciate everything that you and your team have been doing. As you said, the last 12 months have been unlike anything I've seen in my professional career. And we are obviously setting pace and we plan to continue to do so. Thank you so much for your deep partnership. Thank you. Right. Jensen Huang.